Hello everybody. Today we are going to talk about one important topic related to our work. Our topic today is effective classroom management. It's essential for any teacher, who wants to be successful or wants to be efficient, to be aware of different topics related to his work as a teacher. It's very important to be aware of the strategies that can be applied during teaching his lesson. Let's start. The first point we are going to talk about is the classroom management. Is what does a classroom management refer to? Classroom management refers to the skills needed to organize students' behavior and interaction during a lesson to enable teaching to take place more effectively. The second question, what should a teacher do for effective classroom management? For effective classroom management, a teacher should, number one, help students work well as members of one learning community. Number two, provide opportunities for creating a relaxed, non-threatening atmosphere in class. Number three, apply techniques and strategies of effective classroom management with the students. Now let's answer another question. What are the essential elements for a good classroom management? For a good classroom management, a teacher should, number one, present the lesson in an interesting and effective way. Number two, use teaching aids in an interesting and effective way. Number three, establish rapport with students. Number four, have a pleasant and warm personality. Number five, use the body languages by using arms, hands, eyes, smiles, movements, and other gestures during the lesson. Now let's talk about the steps for effective group work. There are some steps that a teacher should follow for effective group work. Number one, should be giving instructions. Number two, checking instructions. Number three, modeling. Number four, grouping and assigning roles. Number five, mentoring. Number six, feedback. I think applied group work technique is important for many reasons. Applying the group work technique is important for the following. Number one, it encourages shy students to take part during the lesson. Number two, it gives the students a chance to learn from each other. Number three, it gives the teacher the opportunity to involve full students during the lesson. Now, why is it necessary to use teaching aids? I think that using teaching aids is very important for many reasons. Number one, they can create a lively atmosphere in class. Number two, they motivate students to take part during the lesson. Number three, they can also help a a teacher to avoid long and confusing explanation. Number 4, they help students understand more easily and more accurately.